This man killed his girlfriend in the church, cut her body into pieces, put them in trash bags along with two dead animals, a goat and a dog. He then took these bags to a riverside where he dumped them, thinking no one would ever trace it back to him. 24 hours later, he and his father, a bishop of Freedom Chapel International, were exposed and arrested for the gruesome killing of a lady, simply known as Anita. How the police found out that it was them who did it would leave you speechless. Around 11 p.m. on the 19th of June 2022, Apostle Kelechi Amadi called a tricycle rider to come take him home from church somewhere in Kubwa, Abuja. When the keke came, Kelechi went inside the compound and brought out three sack bags containing junks. He told the keke man that the bags were actually dustbins that he wanted to throw along the way, and the keke driver did not think too much of it. He charged him 1,000 naira and began the journey. It was when they got to a flyover bridge in Kubwa that Kelechi ordered the driver to stop. This was where he came down from the keke and threw the three bags over the bridge, hopefully to target the river, but it ended up by the side of the river where other trash bags were dumped. After he was done, the keke man continued the journey and dropped him where he wanted to go. The tricyclist did not really think too much of it. Even when the tricyclist got home to close for the day, he noticed blood stains on the seat of his keke. And it still did not occur to him, it did not register to him that something weird or off must have been in that bag that the Apostle Kelechi was carrying. So he cleaned the blood and just assumed maybe it was some sports meat from the bag. However, the next day, when the keke driver was passing the Kubwa flyover, he noticed a crowd of people by the bridge and realized that they were all staring at something. And as usual, the keke man came down from his keke to ask what the people were looking at. And that was when he was told that they saw a bag full of mutilated female remains. The bags were discovered by a group of scavengers earlier that morning while they were searching for junks. When one of the scavengers saw the sack bag, he tore it open, thinking he would find some valuables, only to find pieces of human body parts. When the keke man looked at the bags himself, that was when it occurred to him that those were the same bags the man he picked from the night before were carrying in his keke. That was when the blood he cleaned in his keke now clicked on his head. And instantly, the keke man knew who killed the woman in that bag, and he knew the right thing to do in that instance. Immediately, the tricyclist went to inform the head of association of keke in the area. It was them who then told him to go straight to the police. By then, the police had already visited the site. They had even evacuated the body of the woman. They were also beginning investigation. But luckily for them, someone who saw something and knew something decided to speak out, and he even promised to take them to the place where he picked the man who threw the sack bag containing human remains over the bridge. And that was how the police got to the church and picked up a father and son who were ministers in that church, holding them responsible for the murder of the unknown woman in Kubwa Bridge. As at the time of making this video, not much is known yet apart from the fact that they've all been caught, or they've both been caught. And apart from the fact that they have both agreed and accepted that they were the ones behind the mutilated female body part at Kubwa River. The only problem now is they are both denying that they were the ones who killed the girl specifically. Kelechi is claiming that it was his father, Mr. Amadi, that did the killing, while he only did the disposing. While Mr. Amadi, or Bishop Amadi is claiming that he is not the one who did the killing of the girl, that the girl was his son's side chick, and that he was only helping him out as a father to, you know, cover his tracks. He is claiming that it was his son, Kelechi, who did the killing. So right now, they are both pointing fingers at each other, looking for someone to take the fall. But my thing is, I don't care at this point which of them did it. All we know is they both did it, and they both should face equal punishment in accordance with the law. It's been also said that Kelechi's wife has disassociated herself from the family of her husband. I guess she's going to file for divorce, and if that's the case, it's good for her. This is not a good look for her and the children. Personally, I feel like this keke rider deserves an accolade, because let's face it, these things happen every day, and let me not lie, a lot of keke drivers, motorcycle drivers and taxi drivers see a lot of these kinds of evils being committed on a daily. They see a lot, but the thing is, many of them don't speak out of fear. But this keke driver was brave. He did not care how it's going to look. He did not care if he might be implicated. He saw something and spoke up. And thanks to him, the young lady who was killed in that brutal manner will get her justice. This is the more reason why we encourage people to speak out when they see something off. Because like I've said, many of these motorcyclists, other people in transport business, they see a lot. They know a lot. If half of them could actually speak out what they've seen, many people who have been killed unjustly and illegally may get their justice. So whoever this keke guy was, he is the hero of this story. Another problem now is that we don't know why these two people killed the woman and why they also killed a dog and a goat. Because don't forget, there was a dog, a dead dog and a goat found in one of the sack bags that was thrown into the river, along with the pieces of the female human remains. Is this for some kind of money ritual to boost their members in their church? Or was this something else they did on a daily? Was this something they've been doing for a long time? Is this some kind of tradition they have to do? Which would mean that this may not be the first time or the first victim that they are killing. And mind you, the killing is believed to have been carried out in their church at night
on a Sunday after church.
So which means there's a chance that the victim might have just been a member of the church, somebody that they had asked to stay back for special prayers, for special delivery. The person said might not even be a side chick to the man, because the sources are claiming that it was the girlfriend of this guy, the side chick of him, of Kelechi, that was killed. But what are the chances that this was just a random member in the church that they were using to, you know, looking forward to using for money rituals? It's been said that the police has sealed the church and, you know, checked the entire compound. As long as it has to do with these so-called men of God, I am not surprised. It was just a matter of time for them to start getting exposed one by one. But you guys, let me know what you think. Do you think that this is a case of money rituals? Or is he really trying to protect his son from accidentally killing his girlfriend? And is it possible that this may not be the first time that they are doing such a thing? Let me know what you think.